Thank you, Linda. Again, I'm Kelly Mackey. I'm the Regional Director of Strategic Partnerships with DAS's Apprenticeship and Workforce Innovation Unit. And I'm accompanied by Tsegay Arefaine, Strategic Business Analyst, also with the DAS's Apprenticeship and Workforce Innovation Unit. So who are we? We are a unit that's been established by the prior governor, essentially to develop registered apprenticeship programs in non-traditional sectors. Our unit was bifurcated to allow for us to focus on development of apprenticeship programs in industries such as information technology, advanced manufacturing, healthcare, public sector, biotech, financial services, insurance, logistics, among many others. So what do we do? We do a number of things, including educating the public on the benefits of registered apprenticeship program, which in turn provides employers with a viable, time-tested workforce recruitment strategy that allows them to get the skilled workers that they need. Through this process, our strategic business advisors assist with the structuring and registering of the actual apprenticeship and pre-apprenticeship programs. This process gives workers the skills that they need in order to learn ideal and in-demand roles that they're seeking to enter. This process also allows a strengthening of alliances. By virtue of development of the Registered Apprenticeship Program, it brings together industry, labor, education, our government, and facilitates those critical partnerships in order to create a Registered Apprenticeship Program. And then lastly, through the process, our strategic business advisors provide a personalized support system to help you develop your program from beginning to end. This also involves helping to bring potential opportunities for funding streams and to ensure that you're complying with all of the necessary rules and regulations associated with a state registered apprenticeship program. California is the national leader in apprenticeship. In fact, we have 5 times the number of registered apprentices as the state with the next highest total. Currently, we have just north of 96,000 registered apprentices, about 130 registered pre-apprentices. We have roughly 36,000 participating employers who provide the critical on-the-job training throughout the state of California for our apprentices. We have about 300 active educational institutions, and that number continues to grow as we look to develop registered apprenticeship roles in 4-year colleges and universities that require upper division coursework. And then lastly, we graduate roughly about 8,000 apprentices every year. As employers look to build their 21st century workforce to meet the demands of a global market economy, increasingly a number of these sectors and employers within these sectors are turning to the registered apprenticeship model to meet that challenge. Here is a landscape of what our current development looks like in the area of programs that have either been established or are currently being developed. Let's start with the information technology sector. Our first ever public-private partnership was established with IBM. This was a program focusing on development of registered apprenticeship roles in 3 separate mainframe domain occupations. Secondly, we have a critical partnership with Amazon that includes mechatronics and robotics, software test specialist, and another IT role as well. We're currently developing a program with the Sony Corporation, and that program is focusing on IT sales and marketing specialist roles. We have a number of cybersecurity apprenticeship programs, some of which are included here. They include Palo Alto Networks, the San Francisco International Airport, Adaptive LLC. Secondly, we have a partnership with CCSSF, which Tsegay will talk about later in the presentation, focusing on the 2 occupations you see before you. And then lastly, perhaps the best illustration of how this model can be integrated into an employment setting, whether it's a small, mid, or large multinational corporation, Slow Partners, which brings together a consortium of small employers focusing on the development and deployment of cybersecurity apprenticeship programs. There are roughly 9 or 10 occupations, and these are centered around cybersecurity roles. Second, in our healthcare industry, we have partnerships with 3 of the healthcare giants in this country, first of which is Kaiser, secondly, Dignity Health, both of which have apprenticeable approved occupations and a number of allied healthcare roles. We're currently developing a clinical laboratory scientist occupation for Dignity Health, as well as a partnership with Sutter Health focusing on health facilities technician. The state of California developed the first ever LVN to RN registered apprenticeship program. Currently, we have three iterations of this model with partnerships in academic institutions throughout the state. This program was featured at the National Institutes of Health annual conference back in 2018 and has been deemed a model for the nation by the Pew National Trust. We're also working with the California Community Health Clinics to develop a number of IT and healthcare roles so that cross-pollination between IT and healthcare. And then lastly, we're working on a partnership with a Bay Area consortium, which consists of five counties, focusing on the development of a medical assisting occupation. California has led the nation in development of registered apprenticeship programs in the public sector. We launched the first ever government operations IT apprenticeship program focusing on networking. We have since added additional occupations and will be developing a cybersecurity statewide apprenticeship program in the spring of next year. Some of the occupations that you see before you have either been established or are currently in development. Not unlike the state of California, so too have our county and city governmental partners been struggling to find those critical skilled workers to fill many vacancies within their organizations. And that extends to the special districts and municipalities as well. We've developed a partnership with San Joaquin County that focuses on legal occupations, including legal assistant and paralegal, as well as information technology. We're currently developing a program for Yuba County, focusing on the occupations outlined here on the slide. And then lastly, we're working with the mayor's office in Los Angeles County to focus on the development of a number of roles, including IT-focused occupations. Lastly, in the advanced manufacturing space, we have a partnership with Tesla, focusing on tool and die specialist. And then finally, a partnership with the largest winery in the world, Ernest & Julio Gallo, with the occupations outlined on the slide.
The talent shortage, what does it mean? The talent shortage is real, and we are looking to address that through registered apprenticeship. A study examined 700 healthcare organizations, and in the past year, 75% of the healthcare industry has been infected with malware. Cybersecurity job postings have gone up 74% over the past years in the US. And on a global scale, there would be 3.5 million unfilled cybersecurity jobs by next year. Government, retail, and technology are the industries that received 95% of all breach records in 2016. They have become a popular target because of the high level of personal information in their records. The average cost of data breach this year will exceed well over $150 million. And unfortunately, 80% of small businesses that have 50 or fewer employees that experience a data breach will go out of business within a year. Unscheduled disruption resulting in cyber threats are costly and potentially disastrous. The CDT estimates almost a 40% vacancy rate in IT-related positions over the next half decade. The cybersecurity job reports again estimated that there will be 3.5 million unfilled cybersecurity positions by the end of next year. There are currently just not enough applicants with the right mix of skills to fill these jobs. We have some staggering significant data that is troubling here in the state of California. It is estimated that there are currently north of 72,000 cybersecurity job openings, and at a national level, there are 500,000 cybersecurity job roles that are unfilled. It was these staggering data points that in part prompted us to develop these IT cyber apprenticeship programs, in which I'll talk about in the next slide. Slow Partners is an excellent example of employers coming together and really addressing these staggering vacancy rates in the IT and cyberspace. This program was developed to train apprentices in their respective discipline. These occupations range from computer support specialists to network security administrators. Currently, there are 16 participating employer partners, ranging from small, mid-size to large, and we are certainly expecting that list to grow. They are partnered with the San Luis Obispo County Office of Education, who is the local education agency partner that sanctions and assists in the development of the curriculum, which is complemented with the on-the-job training provided by the employer that hires on the apprentices. Lastly, all of this is built around the California Apprenticeship Initiative grant that helps offset some of the initial costs of the development of this apprenticeship program. The City College of San Francisco Information Security Analyst Apprenticeship Program really addresses the need for qualified information security analysts. This program was developed to train apprentices in information security. This program lasts about a year and a half and consists of a range of 2,100 to 2,700 on-the-job training hours, complemented with 157 and a half hours of related instruction. Currently, there is a range of different participating employers, ranging from the City and County of San Francisco to the Palo Alto networks. They are partnered with the City College of San Francisco, who is the local education agency partner that sanctions and assists in the development of the curriculum, which again is complementing the on-the-job training that is provided by the employers that hire on these apprentices. Lastly, just like SLO, all of this is built around the California Apprenticeship Initiative grant that helps offset some of the initial cost of developing this apprenticeship program.
So what is the construct of this gold standard model? The apprenticeship framework consists firstly of a template. So the basic fundamentals of the registered apprenticeship model consists of one of two areas. The first is the theoretical component consisting of related and supplemental instruction. The vast majority of our programs have roughly 144 recommended related and supplemental instruction hours per year. The second piece is the practical application component, which is on-the-job training. The majority of our programs have roughly 2,000 hours of on-the-job training annually per year, which is roughly the equivalent of full-time work. Lastly, all of our standards are built with a progressive wage scale. This allows an apprentice to move through the program, successfully complete certain competencies, and potentially be given an opportunity to have an increase in their salary over the course of 2, 3, or 4 periods, depending upon how the program is structured. The employer sets the wage and they set the increases. The apprentice just needs to successfully complete those competencies. So delving more deeply into RSI, what is it? Essentially, it's approved curriculum specifically tailored to your operational needs. It instills a theoretical understanding for the apprentice so that they can then in turn go and practically apply what they've learned in the classroom the night before. Classes in many instances count towards a degree, either a 2 or 4 year degree in college. And then lastly, the delivery system consists of lectures provided through hands-on demonstrations, presentations, and examinations, in some cases proctored. Here's an illustration extrapolated directly from one of our approved standards for information security analyst. This is a breakdown of some of the coursework that's offered that the apprentice will take during the duration of their apprenticeship program. On-the-job training, this is the practical application piece of our registered apprenticeship model. It allows for work processes to be established by you, so the employer determines the competencies for the program. It's a learn-by-doing model, a work-based model that can be integrated into your strategy. And then one of the highlights of the registered apprenticeship model is the mentorship component that allows for apprentices to be supervised in many instances by somebody who is already serving in the role in which they are apprenticing in. And then lastly, as I referenced on a prior slide, all of our apprenticeship programs are built around a progressive wage scale with wages set by you, the employer. Here, taken directly from our standards, is an example of some of the competencies or what we call on-the-job training, focusing on the information security analyst. Here's an example of a progressive wage scale taken directly from one of our standards for the information security analyst role. It starts with a high-skilled worker wage of $47.95 per hour. The apprentice will start at about $33 an hour and will have the opportunity to get 4 separate increases throughout the duration of their apprenticeship program. The program in this particular case is built around a 2-year apprenticeship program. One of the first questions I'm asked when we develop a registered apprenticeship program for employers is, where am I going to get the skilled workers? Where are we going to source from? First and foremost, we always recommend that employers start with their own incumbent workforce. Why? Because in many instances, these individual employees have already checked a box for you. These are individuals who've been a part of your organization. They understand its mission, its goals. They have a strong orientation to the type of work that you do and understand the DNA of what makes your organization tick. In many instances, for that reason, they can be very strong candidates for your apprenticeship program. The second area that we encourage our employers to look to are our academic institutions throughout the state of California. We have strong ties to our academic institutions at the community college level, the California State University and UC system, and our adult schools and county offices of education. In many instances, these are students who are already taking classes in the apprenticeable occupations that you're looking to fill. The next area is industry displaced workers. These are individuals who had prior work experience in the IT space. Perhaps they were in a different type of role, and they're looking for a route back into the sector, and the apprenticeship model allows them to get the specific training for the apprenticeable role that you're trying to bring into your organization. And finally, you have the public at large. These are individuals who are interested in moving into the information technology sector, but don't have the required academic or on-the-job training experience in order to meet the minimum qualifications for many of these roles.
Let's talk about pre-apprenticeship. Pre-apprenticeship is a term that is used loosely and has many different definitions. So in order to understand pre-apprenticeship, we must first define it. Pre-apprenticeships are programs that prepare individuals to enter and succeed in a registered apprenticeship program, and then ultimately a viable career. Unlike registered apprenticeship programs that typically take a year or more and include paid on-the-job training, pre-apprenticeships are shorter in length and they may last from a few weeks to a few months and may or may not include wages or stipends. Pre-apprenticeship programs have a direct link to at least one existing registered apprenticeship program through a memorandum of understanding or a linkage agreement, and provide career counseling, job search tips, and resume preparation that enables the pre-apprentices a pathway to employability through a registered apprenticeship program. However, the registered apprenticeship program should also emphasize that direct entry is not always guaranteed. Pre-apprenticeship programs can also prepare individuals for certificates, or at least place them in the position to be prepared for certificate examinations. Here's an illustration of what a pre-apprenticeship program looks like. This is the SLO Partners in conjunction with the San Luis Obispo County Office of Education. This pre-apprenticeship program exposes pre-apprentices to occupations of their choice, ranging from software developer to IT networking. Their linkage is with SLO Partners Apprenticeship Committee that provides the possibility of an entry to their registered apprenticeship program. The length of this program is anywhere between 10 to 20 weeks, depending on the occupation the pre-apprentices decide to pursue. Lastly, all of this, again, is built around the California Apprenticeship Initiative grant that helps offset some of the initial costs of developing this pre-apprenticeship program. Apprentice benefits. Here's the good news for our registered apprentices. There's the opportunity to earn while they learn. While apprentices focus on their career path, they are working full-time and going to school. Apprentices are afforded the opportunities for regular pay increases, which instills a sense of accomplishment as they make their way through their apprenticeship program. Apprentices also learn lifelong skills. Apprentices earn competitive wages. They earn a paycheck from the first day of employment. And as skill levels increase, so do the incremental pay raises. At the end of the apprenticeship program, apprentices are certified as highly skilled and competent workers in their respected occupation. Once the apprentice has completed the apprenticeship program, they can earn state and potentially nationally recognized credentials. According to a 2018 LinkedIn Workplace Learning Report, 94% of employees say that they would stay at a company longer if it invested in their career development.
Next, I'd like to highlight the employer benefits. The first, of course, is your skilled workforce, the ability to attract, train, and retain a pipeline of skilled workers to allow for you to meet your operational needs. Secondly, is the financial aspect of it, improvement in productivity and profitability, and the ability to access state and federal funding streams. This is very different when you have an internal training program. In many instances, you don't qualify for the same type of funding as you do with a registered apprenticeship program. Next, Tsegay highlighted previously the loyalty that employees have toward the employer who's invested in their career development. So it instills a sense of trust. As a result of that, you have high retention rates. Speaking of high retention rates, it reduces recruitment costs and certainly high turnover costs associated with bringing in your workers. And then lastly, and perhaps one of the best elements of the registered apprenticeship program that I like to highlight consistently with employers is the element of the customization feature, the ability to really tailor the program to your specific operational needs, not only in the early development stages, but throughout the duration of the program that you have it embedded into your organization. We can change it as technology changes, as requirements of the industry change. The customization feature is perhaps one of the biggest selling points of the registered apprenticeship programs. According to an economic policy team at the Center for American Progress, 97% of sponsors of registered apprenticeship programs said that they would recommend this program to others, while 80% of the sponsors cited that the greatest benefit of the apprenticeship model was that it helped meet their demands for a skilled workforce. And then lastly, 64% of our program sponsors said that the completion rate for their program was between 90 to 100%, and 26% indicated it was between 70 to 89%. Let's talk about return on investment. According to the U.S. Department of Labor, for every dollar that an employer invests in a registered apprenticeship program, they see a return of $1.47. Not only is there a return on investment for employers, but the public also sees a benefit. For every dollar that our government invests in registered apprenticeship programs, they see a return of $28. Speaking of strong statistically significant outcomes, 87% of our apprentices who complete registered apprenticeship programs are employed upon successful completion. And then lastly, of those individuals who do go through a registered apprenticeship program, on average, they earn over the course of their lifetime $300,000 more than their peers who did not go through a registered apprenticeship program. Next, let's talk about potential funding opportunities for your registered apprenticeship program. First is something very unique in our state. It's called Montoya Funds. No other state has it. These are dollars that are earmarked annually through our state budget. They come in the form of hours that are dispersed by the California Community College Chancellor's Office. They are distributed to each of the local education agencies that participate in registered apprenticeship. They have a reimbursable rate of roughly $6.50 per hour for every hour that the student is in school. When those funds are not available, we encourage our academic institutions to take full advantage of something called apportionment. These are funds that allow for the academic institution to claim the hours that the student is in class while they're in their registered apprenticeship program. Next is the Workforce Innovation and Opportunities Act. These are funds that are distributed through the workforce investment boards, and they focus on the support of on-the-job training components, and in many instances will pay for costs associated with classroom instruction. Next is the Employment Training Panel. Those dollars are really focused on incumbent worker upskilling, funds that can be earmarked for supporting of job creation and training for individuals who work in a workplace. And then lastly, something that we're very proud of, which is the apprenticeship grants that are focused on helping employers offset costs associated with the implementation of their registered apprenticeship programs. Over the last half decade or so, we've seen an unprecedented level of funding coming in from both the federal and state governments. These are dollars that have come in the form of a number of grants, most recently the California Apprenticeship Initiative grants that are funded through state dollars, and the Closing the Skills Gap, which are funded through the federal government. Our hope is that as we continue to navigate through the COVID-19 challenges economically and otherwise, that our employers are going to double down and put Californians back to work. Our hope is that we will continue to see those dollars invest in apprenticeship programs which successfully put people in jobs that employers need. So you're an employer and you've determined that you want to register an apprenticeship program. What are the steps that are critically important in order for you to make that happen? First, you'll be assigned to work with a strategic business advisor. A subject matter expert will help you navigate through the steps from beginning to end. The first thing you'll need to do is define your operational needs. That comes in the form of what positions do we need? Secondly, you'll bring in your subject matter experts who will itemize all of the critical components, including the competencies and related and supplemental instruction coursework essential for that job role. And then lastly, you, the employer, will establish the wage scale. That includes the progressive wage scale component from where an apprentice starts to where they end. Secondly, you'll identify your educational partner. This is important for a couple of reasons. First, you want to ensure that they have relevant curriculum that is specifically tied to the apprenticeable occupation role. So you will want to find an employer that has suitable curriculum, ideally already approved, and can deliver that curriculum. That may come in the form of a brick and mortar college or an online service provider. Secondly, you want to ensure that you have an employer that can determine potential opportunities for funding. That could be RSI hours that may be available that I referenced on my previous slide, or there's an interest in exploring with you the opportunity to develop a proposal for a grant. Many of our local education agencies have in-house grant writers that can do a lot of that heavy lifting for you. They will also provide to you a letter of support sanctioning your curriculum and agreeing to be your local education agency partner. Apprenticeship programs may have multiple local education agencies. In some instances, some represent the funding piece and some represent the curriculum piece. The next step is to identify where you're going to source your potential candidates. As I outlined on my prior slide, they can come from a multitude of places, some of which are indicated here. After that, you'll establish your standards. This is where a lot of the heavy lifting can be done for you. Our strategic business advisor will detail out from the template of their choosing, based on your operational needs, all of the critical components that are essential in order for you to establish an apprenticeship program that meets your needs. They will continue to monitor and help and assist along the way with the progression of that apprentice as well. And then lastly, the submission for approval. This is an area that I really want to highlight because we've done a lot of work to ensure that the turnaround time for approval of your program can range anywhere from 45 to 60 days. We've also streamlined our process in a number of other ways. The first is the establishment of the first of its kind in the country dual template. This is a template that allows for you to simultaneously register your apprenticeship program through both the federal and state government at the same time on one document. Why is this important? Because it allows for your apprentices to be recognized both at the federal and state level, and it also opens your organization up to the opportunity to secure funding through both federal grants as well as state grants. So we think, in conclusion, the solution is the apprenticeship model, which will meet industry needs for a high-skilled workforce. This is without regard to the occupation that you're looking to make apprenticeable. But in the case of cybersecurity, we have a real game-changing moment. With the integration of the new curriculum that's been adopted through the proposal from the Governor's Cybersecurity Task Force, we think we have a new opportunity for cybersecurity apprenticeship program development. My hope is that you will think so too. The Apprenticeship and Workforce Innovation Unit has field offices throughout the state of California. So whether you're an employer down in San Diego County, or up in Red Bluff, California, we have a field office of strategic business advisors that can work directly with you and your team to develop a registered apprenticeship program that's going to fit your operational needs. I hope that you will contact that local office at your earliest opportunity to start a discussion about ways that you can get the skilled workforce that you need. Lastly, we want to thank you for the opportunity to present today on the California Registered Apprenticeship Model. We are confident that the integration of this 21st century solution into your current recruitment strategies is going to benefit you by getting you the skilled workforce that you need now and in the future. On behalf of myself and my colleague, Tsegay Arefaine, thank you so much for the opportunity to present today.
Thank you.